So a bracket set looks pretty complicated. There's a lot of pieces. I've made some bracket sets with over 100 pieces. There's a language of brackets, and once you learn the language, it becomes more understandable. And there's standardization and modules. So there's actually only a couple of sizes of material used in the bracket set. The width and the height of a bracket arm is one standard module. The width and the height of this purlin and the hip is a second standard module. And the width and the height of the bearing blocks is a third standard module. So in the beginning, you order 10,000 board feet of this size and 5,000 board feet of that size, and you have big stacks of your standardized material. And first, second, and third tier are all the same dimension. And all the bearing blocks are all the same width and height, and with just some variation in the length. One other point about organization and how to create this building that's 51 meters tall and has 30,000 different parts is you have a master who designs the overall building, and you have submasters. So you would have a master of brackets, for example, and he would probably be part of a lineage in a family that knew how to do all this stuff, understood the language, had models, and could carry out the design. Then from the bracket master, you'd have maybe four assistants who understood what needed to be done. And then you'd have 200 carpenters, and they would be given wooden templates to mark out the wood and cut it. And the submasters would oversee to make sure that the joinery was appropriate. These buildings were built relatively quickly with huge amounts of manpower and sometimes woman power. It's quite astounding the amount of organization and planning that goes into it. But as I mentioned, there's a language, and once you know the language, you can make things happen. There's a way to make it simple and sort of to understand the language of how this is built, and that's to have a plan. So a plan, quite literally, is a view of the structure looking from the top down on a flat sort of ground plane. So this is a plan that I drew, full scale, of the components and the crossings. So this would be a bracket arm here, and this would be a bracket arm here crossing. And I could always check my angles and measurements. And where it was really helpful was in laying out the hip, because I could pick off points off the drawing. Now, of course, you can do this all with a calculator and math, but to me, the sort of attraction and the magic and beauty of geometry is that by drawing the lines, you have the exact measurement you need, and you don't even need to know what number it is. You don't need to know it to 1 or 10 decimal places. You just need to know from the drawing that's exactly the measurement you need. And indeed, up until fairly recently, that's how builders built buildings. The English cathedrals, the Chinese temples, things were drawn in plan, and from that, the components and the layout could be determined.